Hi, welcome to the presentation to the work entitled Proposal of a Methodology Based on Persistence for the Treatment of Diabetic Foot Condition. My name is Manuel Casal-Guisande and I am a PhD student and a researcher from the Department of Design and Engineering from the University of Vigo. In this work, we present a system that can help in the treatment of diabetic foot condition. We want to avoid the deformation of this condition, and if this condition has appeared, we want to help in the monitoring process in order to avoid that it goes to severe conditions. So we are going to divide this presentation in 4 points, starting with an introduction to the topic. Then we are going to describe the system that we propose, also present the methodology that supports its use, and present you the conclusions that we have achieved with this work. So diabetes is known as the disease of this 21st century, being the diabetic foot condition one of the most common and worst problems that is associated with the diabetes. In the worst cases of these diabetic foot conditions, the person that is affected could have the lower limb amputated. It is also the main cause of hospitalization in diabetic patients. It is known that in order to achieve an appropriate healing, the nurse team will have to make an important effort through the care of these patients, and even during a long period of time. So, in order to avoid this, I mean, not only the deformation of the of this kind of ulcers or wounds, I mean also the process of healing in order to avoid more severe situation, it is important to make a continuous monitoring of these patients. So our idea here is to improve the diagnostic process in order to achieve an effective monitoring of these patients. We think that this might help to reduce the impact and the possible effects that are currently associated with late and inappropriate detections. How we are going to do this? Well, we think that we should start with the patient, take information from the patient, the Wagner test, and photographs from the feet of the patient, and other possible information related to risk factors of this kind of patient. Then, this information is going to be first processed with an image processing algorithm, extracting the area per unit of time of wounds, if there are wounds in the skin of the patient, in the feet of the patient. Then this information is going to be evaluated by an expert, the head of the healthcare staff, taking into account the history and other possible information that she considers. Then, this information is going to be sent to a concurrent expert systems that are going to give us some recommendations. Maintain the treatment, consider an alternative treatments, or change the treatment. The expert is going to evaluate these recommendations and decide if we change the treatment, if we don't change, or what we are going to do. That instructions are going to be sent to the healthcare staff, who is going to apply the medical treatment or the instructions to the patient. So now, if we focus in the concurrent expert system box, we are going to the next slide. This is how it works. It is the methodology that we presented last year in Team 19. It combines two kinds of information, the ones which is coming from the expert, and the other is technical data. After being processed by the expert systems, we obtain the expert risk and the technical risk that are combined through the equation we showed you to calculate the global risk that is associated to the risk of the diabetic foot. This system, as you can see, can apply corrections to modulate the standard behavior of the system and adapt it to different situations. And finally, we can see the outputs of the system that give the possible recommendations. So, in this work, we have presented a conceptual design of a methodology that make possible to improve the monitoring and diagnostic process of the diabetic condition. Its use might reduce the detection of possible severe conditions or conditions that need to be reviewed or to change the treatment in order to avoid severe problems. And finally, we think that this might be extended to other kinds of ulcers or problems in the skin. Finally, I just would like to thank you for your attention, and please, if you have any questions, do not hesitate to drop me an email.